Maz,
yeah.
And you say this knee is due to be replaced in a couple of weeks?
This left knee is due to be replaced on the 31st of this month. Yes, I'm a retired nurse, so it's left me with some shoulder problems and neck problems, and I've got two bad knees.
Yeah.
But this one's been replaced, but this one's due to be replaced as well.
All right.
I do have some nerve damage in my right foot, so there's some numbness in there.
All right, okay. Now, what I'm tempted to do first is work on the right knee where there has been a replacement knee. Make sure that is just really, really good, and get that nerve damage out of the foot first, and then I'm going to work on the knee.
Thank you.
Because then you'll have this good leg for support.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, we are divine beings, and this is our body whilst on earth. If the legs start to go, it's about standing up for ourselves.
It's tingling already.
Yeah. It's about you've had to stand up for yourself, and it may be that this has been triggered post-nursing.
Yeah.
And this is, it's like the pain or the discomfort or the knotties of having to stand up for yourself.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've got the surgeon is saying to you, you should have done this, as in healing yourself, years ago.
Yeah, I am a Reiki healer.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't do it so much now, though, but I am a Reiki healer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you should have done this, what I'm doing.
Oh.
You should have done this years ago. You should. Yeah. It's what he's saying to you. Yeah. Your foot, notice how your foot's feeling, and that nerve damage, is it feeling like that still feels the same,
yeah,
or has it changed?
It's changed a little bit, yeah, it doesn't feel as tight.
Cool.
It's not as tight.
Right, now just try walking around. I want you to notice that the right foot and the right knee as you walk.
The right knee definitely feels better.
Awesome.
Definitely feels better.
Yeah.
And that right foot is definitely looser.
Yeah, lovely.
Yeah.
Okay, so they've still got a bit more work, because they've only got about a quarter of the work on the foot. Now, as I'm working on her foot, what's happened within my foot's just suddenly gone tired and drained. And is that how it feels? So I didn't know how it felt, but it's just like, ugh. Like it's collapsed. It's like, don't do anything anymore.
Right.
All right. So let's move that out. Okay. Now, there was a problem with ill-fitting shoes, but not anymore. She's not doing that anymore, right?
It's absolutely spot on. I've always worn the wrong shoes.
Yeah, but not anymore. I'm lucky. My feet always gave me so much jip. My feet are like triangular, seriously. You know, that they don't look like shoe-shaped. I've only ever worn flat shoes, seriously. I just could not stand that feeling of being on my
high heels.
Yeah, couldn't stand it. And thank goodness. Right, another walk around, see how that feels.
That definitely feels easier.
Awesome.
Yeah, that feels easy to stand on. Even the knee feels easier.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Right, now let's do that left side. I feel like we should have a drum roll. Isn't it cool? Alright. And I must say, it's very good to have gentlemen with us. Yeah? In New Zealand, my audience is nearly always all women, and in the UK, gentlemen are coming to my events. And I'll tell you what else is different for me. In New Zealand, I've only had two doctors ever come to my shows, to the best of my knowledge. And in New Zealand, I've already had about four doctors and a surgeon has come and have requested me to work on them. That's great, isn't that, isn't that good?
Yeah,
that's good. And I've still got another 50 shows, so it's exciting. Oh. Right, now, this knee, right, surgeons say sometimes you can be stubborn.
Yeah.
She can. And guess where stubbornness gets stored? In your knees. I'm not just making it up, it's true. Stubbornness gets stored in your knees. All right, so just be aware of that. So we need to be flexible. Sometimes what can happen, and this is specifically for you, but it may apply to others here, particularly ladies, sometimes we give so much, we're caring, we give so much, and then we just get to that thing and we think, oh no, sod this, forget my soldiers now, and then we become rigid. And the thing is, we probably should have set that boundary back then, and then this one here now is actually quite trivial, we need to be so rigid about it, and that's what the energy is that's stuck in the knee. It's like, You're being stubborn now. Mm-hmm. And you're not really stubborn. Stubborn isn't of your nature.
No, it isn't. No.
It's just that you've given and given and given and given.
That's right.
And now you've just said to help you.
Enough's enough.
Yes.
That's spot on.
I know. And so you've got to let that go, though, because you can draw a boundary without it having that energy in there.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, I've not finished yet, but I just want to see, because I'm curious, one of the great tools that, one of my great gifts that has enabled me to do the work that I do is I'm really, really curious. I want to know. And I've only talked about that energy, and I want to see to what extent just that fixes the knee. So just have another walk.
It's improved.
Yeah.
It's improved.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It has. About 25%?
I would say about 20%, yes.
Yeah. Cool. Right, now we're going to do the work. And what he's showing me in the leg looks like limescale, like you get in a kettle. You know, limescale in a kettle is calcium carbonate. Yeah. When there's a lot of minerals in the water's called hard. And when with a soap, it would scum. And typically in Yorkshire, we've got hard water, and you get that limescale in your kettle. My grandma used to put a pebble in there, and the pebble would go white, and that would absorb the calcium carbonate. So if you've got a kettle scumming, that was the old way. I'm sure somebody would sell you something. In fact, we could have a brand of pebbles, Sarah, 20 pounds a time to descale your kettle for you, and people would pay. But it was just some kind of pebble. Yeah, but it would go white, and then us as kids would chalk with that. Anybody else have a grandma doing that? Or is it that? I'm showing the age now, aren't I? But what I'm seeing in your knee looks like calcium carbonate. It probably isn't calcium carbonate, but it's that kind of build-up.
Yeah.
And so even though my hand's going like this, I've got another hand that's like this, going, and scratching it away. But I don't want to...
It's ice cold now.
Yeah.
Ice cold.
Yeah, and that's because they're working on the bone.
Yeah,
working
ice
on the bone.
Cold.
But you see, you were drawn to nursing. It was the healing you wanted to do, really.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not too late. Mm. It's not too late. Mm. You could still help a lot of people. Mm. Now then, I've got to ask this because I'm curious. I've just got the word castle. Did you want to live in a castle?
I've just come back from Scotland and the Lake District. And we've been around castles.
Uh-huh. I'm like, there's one energy fields full with castle, and it's like, does she want to live in a castle?
Yeah.
Isn't it weird?
I've seen loads of castles.
Yeah, they're drifting. Is it once you've seen one, you've seen them all?
Well,
no. It's lovely, isn't it? I like Leeds Castle, I have to say.
Oh, yeah.
Lovely Leeds Castle.
Scotland
which
is amazing.
It's not in Leeds.
No.
It's in Kent, isn't it? Yeah. But it's lovely.
It's so cold.
It is cold. Now, what they're doing is that he's telling me they're building that knee up now. Mm. They're building that knee up. It needed building up. So my understanding is you won't need a replacement knee, but he can do this well enough that you won't need one. Isn't that cool? I'm going to tell you about, he's an American surgeon, and I must do some research on him and get his name. There was an American surgeon some years ago. Let's say he had a dozen patients, all that needed knee surgery. He opened them all up. But half of them, he squirted just with a saline solution and stitched them back up. Another half, he did the traditional operation. Both groups recovered equally well. And the thing that gets me is what made him think to do that. What, you know, there must be something that made him think that if he did that, it was going to work. Right now, we're about possibly 2/3 of the way through, but let's just have a little walk and see. Now, the reason I get you to walk or stretch is I don't do any manipulation because I'm not trained for anything like that.
It's not great in as much. It really is not great in as much.
That's because he scraped all that stuff
out. It's bone on bone. And it's when I walk, that's how it usually is.
Right, so it's not bone on bone anymore. So just get rid of that idea. But it wasn't grating as much, was it?
No, it wasn't grating as much.
He said we were about 2/3 of the way. Would that be fair to say?
Yes.
About 2/3 of the pain has gone?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. I like to check. I like to check that I'm picking up the right information. And then I'm being given a cup of tea. Are you dying for a cup of tea?
I love cup of tea.
See, I pick up all this information when I'm in somebody's space. You'd be able to have one at the interval.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Is isn't it funny? My grandma's generation drank tea. It would calm them down, it would relax them. My mum's generation drank coffee to perk them up and keep them going. Very different drinks.
Yeah.
Very different drinks. I never touch coffee. Don't touch it. Somebody at the interval probably asked me why not, and I'll explain. But I only explain, I'll only ask to be told if you never want to drink coffee again. And if you're enjoying your coffee, if it's your only vice in life, keep your coffee. Don't ask. Don't ask. But knowing what I know, I can't drink coffee anymore, so I choose not to. Right, we're nearly there. Have another walk around. Gosh, she's getting up easier, isn't she?
That one definitely is easier. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, is there any pain in there now?
It just feels different. Even that is, usually I can hear grating, but I'm not. That is pretty damn good, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
And this coming from a retired nurse.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.